Hello and welcome to Off the Bench for the TAC Towards Zero. It's a new season, a new show. We've got a new network partner. We've got a new studio, some new talent and some familiar faces. Got a big show coming up. We'll talk to one of Geelong's favourite sons very shortly. We'll also introduce our new talent. We've headhunted this man. He's an up-and-coming media star, Nathan Currie. We'll welcome back a familiar face, the Weekly Times' Hannah Driscoll. And it's always a pleasure to welcome back the 1997 Best and Fairest winner from the Cats, Liam Pickering. Welcome, Pickers.
Yeah, good to be here, Swatter. It's like back where we belong.
Yeah.
We haven't been back in this situation for a while. We got rid of a bit of deadwood.
Yeah, we got told to find some form somewhere else.
We had to just go back to the seconds, but now we're back in the main game again. And, of course, there's no Hutchie. Win.
Yep.
Well, there's no spud win.
Yep.
So anyway, looking forward to a big year.
Looking forward for a big show. And it's a great pleasure to have our wonderful friends from the TAC on board this year towards zero, a really important road safety campaign. Well, Pickers, we're going to introduce our next guest. He is bigger than Geelong. He is one of Geelong's favourite sons. And you would argue, according to him, he's probably Geraldine's biggest sporting talent. Hello, Bill Brownless.
Hey, Swatto. G'day, Pickers. Nice studio. Like it. Well done, boys.
Yeah, we're working well here, Bill. It's good to have you as our first guest. We thought very, very appropriate.
Yes.
You know, people just haven't had enough of you tonight.
Exactly. Footy show was good. Another good show, wasn't it? Hutch is going, he's flying, and Beck's back. So it's going really well. And then quick change and into you.
Hey, but we're all about you here.
Yes.
You grew up in Geraldine.
Yeah.
Tell us about that area and that town as a kid growing up.
I was born in Urana, actually, a smaller country town. A very, very tiny town, Urana. Grew up there. My old man was a jackaroo. So we used to go around to Deniliquin and Moolamine and went up to Broken Hill Way, and this is me at the Geraldine Force.
Now, where are you, Bill?
I'm up the back corner there, just hunched over. Look at the blonde hair, beautiful. Look at big Sam Katina there, the big bloke. He come from Cobram, well, that happy, because his parents bought a fish and chip shop.
Mate,
he was the biggest player in the league. There I am at the bent over there.
What are you doing?
Now, can you believe this? First premiership, right? That's in 1980. That is the only premiership I've played in. I played in some games at Assumption College, lost all those to Marsland, and then played in four grand finals at Geelong, lost all those. So that's the only premiership I've ever won.
Well, you've still got one, Bill.
Hey?
You've still got one.
Well, just one.
They were kids' premierships. So would you be able to sort of maybe put this on the... I'm going out on a limb here, Bill.
Yeah. What, Liam?
Is there a reason that you played in a lot of runners
no.
up? Like, I mean, I played in a couple with you at Geelong, but seriously.
Well, you lost them too. You were part.
I played in a premiership, a senior premiership at Stawell at least.
Oh, Stawell, fair to come. Me and Ablett did a good job because we kicked 11 between us in 89.
Run us through your resume, Phil.
There it is, there. Born and bred. Well, I was bred in Geraldine. No, I wasn't even bred in Geraldine. As I said, Urana, played Geraldine Demons there, played junior footy. Went to Assumption College Kilmore, did my HSC in 1982, 1983 and 1984. Because I wasn't the smartest bloke. 198 games for the Cats, 441 goals. I see Tomahawk hasn't kicked 441 yet.
Not yet, Stevie J.
Look at him. This is the early days. Look at him there. That's something I could do, jump.
Yeah, we're a good mark. That was in the 94 grand final.
That was a grand final. Went back and kicked. And this
is
one.
It? Is it, Bill? How far out were you, Bill?
85.
Yep.
You watch Tony Liberatore saying things. You can't see it. But that's 85 metres out. I've kicked at 20. It's kicked at 100 metres. And look at Malcolm Blight comes up here very shortly. He tries to get in at the legend. The worst thing was John Barnes caught me and kissed me on the lips.
Hey, Geraldine, it's a place that's special. It must be a special sort of place to go back there and wander into the bakery. What's the significance of wandering into the bakery?
Well, this is every country town has got a very good bakery, and this is some of the superstars from Geraldine. Joe
Kelly.
Byrne, he was with Ned Kelly. He was part of Ned Kelly's gang. Not sure who the ladies are there. And Ned Kelly, Rob, there I am. Look at that.
Adam Cooney, it looks
it's
like.
It's not Adam Cooney. But Kelly robbed Geraldine back in the day, and he locked the two police into the jail and wrote the Geraldine letter. It's very famous. There's some good history for you, boys.
Okay, I'm happy with the history, but what about the Riverina team of the century?
Oh, yeah.
Now, you
surely
would have been,
you're a starter.
Say full forward.
Oh, full forward.
What? On the bench.
Who's B. Moore?
Hey?
Come on.
Lukey Bruce.
Who picked this?
Hey, Kevin Sheedy picked that. That is a fair team, though. There's some gun players in there, but, Bill, you've just made the bench.
I know. Well, I'm happy to make the bench, actually. Jumping Jack Hawkins in the back pocket. Dennis Carroll, a very good player. Paul Kelly, the duck, of course. Paul Kelly in the middle and half forward flank. He's going all right. Longmire, Horse. He'd be disappointed he's not full forward. Frankie Gumbleton, Tom Hawkins. Pretty good side, that. Shane Crawford, of course. So.
Very good side.
See, he's from Finley. We used to go to Finley High. So we had no high school at Geraldine. We'd catch the bus every day. go to Philly, and it was fantastic because you used to have the verandas back then. So Drilledry boys would all sit on the Drilledry veranda, the Finley boys on the Finley veranda, the Tote boys on the Tote, and you weren't allowed to be mates or talk to the other verandas. It was unbelievable back then, the good old days.
The good old days, Bill.
Hey, now you're famous, or you tell us you're famous for that kick against the Bulldogs, but I reckon you're more famous for a certain kick many, many years ago over a wheat silo.
Oh, yes. That is true. And another true story, me and my two mates from Assumption were going to a wedding at West Wylong. Flaggy, my old mate, was getting married there.
Of course.
And on the way, we thought we'd stop in and have it was a hot day. We'd have a couple of frothies. And we got stuck at the bar and we see, what's the story of the footy? And a bloke said, another bloke kicked this footy 12 years ago at the silos across the road. No one has done it since, 12 years.
Yeah.
So a couple of more frothies. We said, get that footy cock. So he pumped it up. And I was one kick only, straight over the silo. I mean, two mates walk in an hour later, they couldn't do it, they've been trying for an hour. Best mates, I'm signing coasters and dunny doors and all that. So we jump in the car, we had a designated driver.
Well, keep talking, Bill, we're going to show the vision, but keep talking.
You got the vision.
No, it's a good story.
Well, here it is, here, this is it. This is a young me at Maroul. This is the place, Maroul, on the way to West Wallong.
How high you reckon it was?
99 feet. That's him. There it is there. They've got a knot. Here it is. Look at this. So it was a platform and straight. Oh, Liam, look at that. I went back 5 years later and they kicked it over me. But we made the wedding. We went and saw Flaggy's wedding. But that was something. And I went back a couple of times because they'd have a tractor pull. And they'd have yabby races at Maroul. So it was a big day. It was good.
Well,
good
done, Bill. And we've got a little token of our appreciation, which will resonate with you.
What do you think I'd give him? Seriously.
Let's see. What have you got there, Liam? Oh, my favourite. Frothies. Carlton Draft. Brewery Fresh.
Well done, Bill.
I've got one young boy I want to mention.
Yeah, go.
Plays for Yakandandra under-17s in the country up there in the Tlingiturton District League. He's only 15. He's kicked 101 goals already. 101. He's only 15. Plays in the under-17s. Jay Hillary. He's a star. One to watch there.
We'll keep an eye out.
Black book it for me, Bill.
I'll give it to you.
Not sure they'll make the weekend picks. And a nice little segue. Time now for our Carlton Draft Team of the Week. That's all thanks to our great mates at Carlton Draft. Born and bred since 1864.
Ruffies.
Who are we looking at?
We're looking at Maryborough this week, Swanee, because fair to say they've had a bit of a drought. They're a very old club, as you can see here.
Haven't won a game in 1,049 days.
Yes, we're not going to talk about that because they won last week. 11 senior premierships. John Nichols, the great John Nichols. Jed Adcock, of course. Stuart Cramery. I think Troy Chaplin's from there as well.
And
the reason we brought this up was because they beat Castle
Wayne. Bill's old team.
Yes.
Hey? It's their first win since round 16, 2014.
Gee.
So they've had a fair drought, I would have thought you'd put it, Bill.
Yeah.
That's a good effort, so well done to Maryborough. Yeah. They're a team
great
of the week.
Effort. And assuming that both players and supporters went down to the Cumberland Hotel in Castlemaine, that's a place you need to go. Hey, Bill, always a pleasure to have
you
on board. Thanks
good
very much
Billy.
For joining us.
That's a perfect picture.
that is Bill Brownless, and he's going to take our great friend's product, Carlton Draft, away. That was our Carlton Draft Team of the Week. We're going to take a break. It's all thanks to our great friends at the TAC. Great to have the show back on Channel 9. When we come back, we unveil our very new media talent, Nathan Currie. Liam Pickering, Wayne Schwass, Off the Bench TV with more after this. Welcome back to Off the Bench for the TAC Towards Zero. Safer speeds, roads, people and vehicle means that serious injuries and a zero road toll is possible. That's a really important message thanks to our very great mates at the TAC. Tell you what, Piggers, it's time now for our country footy wrap. It's all thanks to Kiwa Greyhound Racing Victoria, supporting 3,000 jobs in Victoria. We had a lot of work to do in the off-season. We're back on a new network. Great to be back with Channel 9. It's where we belong. We had to get rid of some Oldwood, Hutchie and Spud. Hannah Driscoll we're going to meet shortly. But Roz Lanigan has been a big part of our show and there have been big shoes to fill.
Yeah, they have. And we've cast a very wide net.
We did.
And we've come up with a young man from Channel 9.
Yes.
His name's Nathan Currie.
Yeah.
And he joins us now.
Welcome, Nath.
Big introduction. Thank you, boys. Good to be on.
Now, you're a local Geelong boy. Am I right in saying that?
I am. Played for Drysdale in the Ballarat Football League. Only under 18s. It was pretty evident early on I was better at reporting football than playing it.
Right, well, what we'll do is we're going to start you off, and we're going to probably start up north.
Okay, let's do it.
Where do you want to go?
Ovens and Murray.
Good place to start.
All right, good upset in the Ovens and Murray. Wodonga Raiders got over the line against Wangaratta. A really, really big upset there. The only concern for Raiders was that Brody Filo, their gun recruit, copped an ankle injury, but their star, Jack Demizio, has told Nine Local News that he should be right to play in the Wodonga Derby this weekend against the Bulldogs, which is great news for them.
Wodonga. Is that Darren Creswell's team?
He's the Raiders coach, so right. Yeah, doing good things up there at the moment. If we look at the ladder, Wangaratta has now dropped out of the top five, which is a bit annoying. I was hoping they'd challenge Albury this year because the Tigers just get the job done every year at the moment.
I tell you what, there are some great, and I mean great players that come out of the Hampton League too, mate, just to let you know.
Oh, here we go.
Turn it up, sort of.
Are we looking? Who are we looking at?
I think we're actually talking about your old club. Is that right? North
Warrnambool? That's it. Photo on the wall, but carry on.
Yeah, well, they had a win. They've won four out of the last five, but wasn't entirely convincing. Up against Terang Mortlake, 37 points at half time. Blood stormed home, 8-4 in the second half to just lose by 13 points. So Eagles got the win, but yeah, they'd want to be doing some more promising things, I think, in the next few weeks.
Let's have a look at the ladder after this. And you're claiming North Warrnambool because you've got your photo on
the wall. No, they're claiming me.
No, you were actually drafted from South Warrnambool.
Oh, was that North Warrnambool first to go to South?
You switched allegiances.
Yes, of course he has. Now, Port Ferry, that's Brad Scholl's old mob.
Yep. Got rid of him and they're winning.
I was going to say, when he was coaching, they changed their nickname for the Fairies, but they're actually now, they're back in business. So.
About the Ballarat Footy League?
Yeah, well, East Point's had its second draw for the season, and usually that would be annoying for teams, but for the Eagles, I think that shows that the young team can match it with the best sides now. Drew with the reigning premiers, Bacchus Marsh. Now, this was another crazy game. Bacchus Marsh was up by 40 points at quarter time, just four at half time, and then, of course, we had the draw. So, really great signs for East Point, but, yeah, Bacchus Marsh, they're now two wins, 2 points below the top two, as you can see on the ladder. Daly and Lake Wendouree doing some really good things up there, Pickers.
The Lakers have been a good team for a number of years, and Daly, they're coached by Heath Scotland, I believe.
Yeah, did his hammy a couple of weeks ago, but yeah, they're looking really good so far, about halfway mark of the Ballarat Footy League.
And well, the AFLW was a raging success, and Darabin has won everything under the guidance of Daisy Pearce. Surely in the VFL Women's, the Darabin are sitting comfortably on top again.
Well, that's not the case at the moment, Swatter. Diamond Creek is up the top. And then in second spot is Melbourne Uni, who we're taking a look at right now. They got over the line against Geelong. The game opened up in the last quarter, but it was pretty much Melbourne Uni the whole way. Really pleasing signs, though, for Bendigo local Elise Strawn. She was playing for Geelong and was best of field. Now, she's trying really hard to get an AFLW contract, so she did her chances no harm there.
Lily Mithen's in that team.
Daughter of Anthony.
Anthony Mithen's
good friend of
daughter.
The show.
Yeah, and of course, Ali Blackburn, the gun, Western Bulldogs, VFL, AFLW player as well. Diamond Creek are doing a good job, aren't they? And the two teams, as you mentioned, Geelong and Box Hill is the Hawthorn. Looking for licences in this competition, Swatter.
That's not what you want to see.
You'd want to be going a bit better than that.
Yeah. Hey, we love a good upset win, Pickers. There was one in the Castlemaine District Footy League.
Yeah, Malvern got the job done, I believe.
Over Campbell's Creek, which is Malden's first win of the season. Great news for the Bombers. They were 25 points down at quarter time. Stormed home, kicking 11-6 to just 6-3 thereafter, which is just brilliant news for them. Denoli did it a few weeks ago in the same league, so it's good to see Molden get a win as well.
Well, I'm not sure if you're a fan of the Greyhounds, but Pickers and I absolutely love the Greyhounds. And Pickers, talking about upset wins, Luna Evening got the job done.
Unbelievably, big odds too. We're looking at the number three here.
Inside run.
Yeah, he gets the inside run, the white dog. Yeah,
straight
not,
track.
Not really. This is at Hillsville, Swatter.
Yep. Good track.
At the odds of $29, not in the picture at the moment. The trainer didn't have anything on it, but just watch it dart through here. Just watch it dart through the Luna.
I tell you, the trainer, if I could find my notes, is an asparagus farmer, did not have a single brass razoo on his dog.
It's unheard of. It's unheard of stuff. So
unbelievable.
At $29.20, you don't want to be sending them around nude, as they say. You need to have a little something on them, I would have thought. An asparagus farmer from Currie, Rub.
Yeah, Peter Matinovic.
That's it. Yeah. Pete, shame on you. Hey, Nath, nice start. Good debut.
Thanks,
very
boys.
Good. We look forward to having you back next week. Look forward to Nathan Currie doing some great work. That's all thanks to our very dear friends at Greyhound Racing. That was our Country Footy Wrap. When we come back, a familiar face, the Weekly Times leading sports journalist, Hannah Driscoll, joins Pickers and myself off the bench for the TAC Towards Zero.
Welcome back to Off the Bench for the TAC. Time now for our weekly footy wrap, thanks to the Weekly Times. The voice of country footy, and for many of you who have followed the show over the last few years, it's great to welcome back a familiar face, Pickers, the queen of country footy in Victoria, Hannah Driscoll. Welcome, Hannah.
Thank you very much for having me again.
And congratulations, I believe you scooped the pools over summer.
I don't know if scoop the pools is the right one, but we did get a few awards, which was really nice. The Weekly Times took out the best non-daily newspaper coverage, and we also won a prize for a feature on Peter Knights, the former Vic Country coach. So Spud has got a lot to live up to when he takes over the reins in a couple of weeks.
And well done. And well done. That was our collective award. Off the Bench also won an award for a feature story as well.
We
so we had a great year last year.
On the women
about the work that we do. Yes, absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely.
It was a beautiful story.
Hey, we always like to focus at the beginning of a new season with our program about AFL players that have gone back into country footy this year. Who are some of the names and where have they gone?
Well, you've already mentioned a few so far in the show, but there's a few other big names. Chris Dawes is one. He's headed back out into the Nepean Football League. He's joined Sorrento and actually leading the, probably unsurprising, leading the goal kicking out there. He kicked 4 on the weekend and his biggest bag, I think, this year has been 10 against Rye. So not a bad recruit there for Sorrento, who's leading the way. A few others to mention, Cameron and Luke Delaney, the brothers, they've headed back home to Grovedale. So it's always nice when players go back to their old junior clubs. That's also happened. We mentioned Heath Scotland before. He went back and he's coaching his old club, so that's a Dali, so that's really nice to see. There's been a few down the Alberton League. Brent McCaffer is down coaching at Kilcunda Bass, and he took on the boys at Daleston on the weekend in a close game.
Let's talk about this AFL salary cap, well, the country salary cap point system. What's the latest on that? How's it coming along?
It's been an interesting couple of weeks, particularly for the salary cap. There's still a few clubs in the last couple of weeks that are finalising the paperwork, but more so in the points. Just in the last couple of weeks, it all seems to be going really smoothly. And then just in the last month or so, there's been a few hiccups along the way with clubs being penalised. In one case down, the most recent case is up in the northeast. Goorambat has actually lost their premiership points for a win that they had, and they also received a suspended fine.
Well, I was at Daleston during the week, earlier this week, and I can tell you the point system versus the salary cap, that club believes the point system has been the best thing that has been introduced to the leagues across the state. Hey, what about some of the drought breakers? We love an upset.
We love an upset, and there's been some great ones so far this year. We mentioned Maribara just earlier, but here we go. This is a feature that we did on Newcomb Power. How's this getting your first win in 4 years?
Had a fair few people probably tell me I'm crazy, taking over one of the biggest jobs in country Victoria, I suppose. But the more that people sort of spoke like that, the more it attracted me to the job, I guess, because I sort of thought it's a good opportunity to prove a point.
It was pretty rough the first couple of years. Like the first year, we were getting beaten by like 200 points. There's even a couple of like 300 point losses and that sort of stuff, which is, makes it tough to turn up to training on a Tuesday after that.
We've had 10 years without any real success. Going back 4 years ago, I think we had 3 wins, which was our best year in that 10-year period up until date. So really, it's been a battle.
Perception is just easy beats and a bit of a rabble, I suppose. Once I met the people, I was almost a little disappointed in myself that I'd sort of maybe perceived it that way as well. And that gave me a little burning fire, I suppose, to prove people wrong as well, for the good people that I did meet.
Some people get disheartened by losing. Other people sort of see it as a challenge.
Human nature says they want to be successful in the club that they're going to, and they want to play in finals if they possibly can. So really, in that period where we've been down, it's been a credit to the players that have come and represented the club.
Concentrate, Al. Concentrate. You've got to wait till that ball's in your hands, mate, before you can kick it. Jesse, you'll be in the ruck Saturday, mate. Nick Jago's going on holidays. So you're the man, son.
We played Port Arlington on the weekend. We thought we were a good show against them.
We were 26 points in front at half time, so you feel as though there's a good chance of winning. And when we held that lead at the three-quarter time break, it was a matter of can a side score 5 goals against a side that's on a bit of a roll as we were.
They showed resilience and stood up when it mattered, and which is probably the biggest thing I'm proud of, because I wasn't out there and I wasn't able to talk to them, so they had to do it themselves.
Sort of just gratified all that work that we've put in over the past 4 years for some, a couple of years for others and all that sort of stuff. So, yeah, it makes it all worthwhile.
It simply means that there's a light at the end of the tunnel. I mean, it motivates you to keep going now because the success we've seen from Saturday, we believe we can see that happen again in the near future.
I think I learnt so far that my philosophy on football's right. Good people bring good results is my football philosophy, and I think that's probably, I've probably learnt that that's true so far. But, I've got a long way to go yet, but yeah.
Yeah, welcome. Well done to Newcombe. Well done to you, Hannah. Great to have you back. If you want to read Hannah's articles, that's the place to go, or theweeklytimes.com.au. We do like a good photo too.
Yeah, the Weekly Times photo of the week this week. It's an absolute beauty too. It's the photo is actually of the umpire, which is Phil Oppie, who umpiring in the Sunraysia Football League, umpiring his 900th game, if you can believe
it.
That is a great, it's a great achievement, isn't it?
Well unbelievable. Done. Well 900 done, games. Well done, Oppie. Well done, Hannah. We're going to come back. Pickers and I, we've got our tips and a couple of other things. Off the bench, thanks to the TAC. More to come. Welcome back to Off the Bench. Time now for our great country footy clashes for the TAC. Towards zero, safer speeds, roads, people and vehicle means that serious injury and also zero road toll is possible. Where are we going this week, Pickers?
We're going to the Bendigo Football League and traditional rivals Golden Square and Strathfield Say, of course, seven of the eight last premierships between them. They've already met this year, 14-point win to Golden Square. I think they can do it again, this time at Triple M Park against Strathfield Say.
All right, very good. Pickers, good luck to those two teams. Thanks, Pickers. Thanks to all of our guests and thanks to you. Great to be back on a new network. Hope you have a great weekend. We'll see you again same time next week.